Hey guys, this is Yi from ExcelCloud.com with another Excel tool to share with you. This time, I'm going to show you a tool I've put together that can automatically download historical exchange rates right into Excel. And with this tool, you can download your historical currency data with a click of a button. So here we go. This is the URL where you can download that file, or you can get there by Googling ExcelCloud, C-L-O-U-T, historical exchange rates, and it should be the first link in the search result. Let's click on download and open the file. Now, because the file was downloaded from the internet, the first time you open this file, you may get this security warning. We need to click on enable editing, and this file contains macros. We need to enable the macros by clicking Enable Content. And it's important that you enable the macros because it's the macros that's going to automatically download your foreign exchange rate data. This Excel file basically comes with a form as you see here. And all you have to do is fill out this form and the macros will take care of downloading the currency data you specified. Over here, you have a currency codes reference table in case you need to look up any currency code. Now, I'm going to show you how quick and easy it is to get your historical foreign exchange rates so you can focus more on your historical analysis instead of searching for data. First, we need to specify the currency pairs we like to download. For example, let's change the currency pairs over here to say EUR/USD for Euro versus US dollar, USD/CAD for US dollar versus Canadian dollar. Make sure you have that slash in between the currency pair so that the macros can recognize the currency pairs you've chosen. Just enter the currency pairs in a list like this. Next, let's set the from date to say August 1st, 2000 and the to date to August 1st, 2010 so that the spreadsheet will automatically download 10 years worth of historical currency data. And last, you have the option to set the frequency of your data. If you set the frequency to daily, you're going to get the exchange rate for each weekday. Weekly would give you the exchange rate on the last day at the end of each week. So you'll get the exchange rate on the last day at the end of each selected period. You have other options such as monthly, quarterly, and yearly. Normally, we'd keep the frequency at daily, so we get all the historical exchange rates for every weekday. So now we're ready to click on this Download Data to New Sheet button, which is the centerpiece of this tool. When you click on this button, what's going to happen is the specified historical exchange rate data will be automatically downloaded and organized into a new sheet within this file. If you look over here, you have two sheets in this file right now, the form and sheet 1. As soon as you click on this button, a new sheet with the automatically downloaded exchange rate data will be added. So let's click on the download button and send the macros to work. And you see a new sheet called Sheet 2 has been added. Let's go to Sheet 2 and check out the currency data we just downloaded. We have the dates in one column and the historical exchange rates for each currency pair in separate columns. Now, a quick note about the data. The foreign exchange rate data is downloaded from Quandl.com, Q-U-A-N-D-L. Quandl is like the Wikipedia for financial data. The currency data is pulled from one of Quandl's currency data sets that covers a broader set of currency pairs, even including some that are not traded in the foreign exchange market. However, there's a catch. In an email exchange with Quandl's CEO, I found out that there's no timestamp for the data, which means we don't know what time the currency rates were recorded. That's because these daily rates are derived from multiple sources, such as exchanges, brokerages, and central banks. Despite the lack of a timestamp, the historical currency rates can be used to spot trends or large movements, and Quandl offers unlimited access so you can download as much data as you need right from this file. In very rare occasions, Quandl could be unavailable possibly due to maintenance, and in this case, just try downloading your data again at another time. And if the issue persists, don't hesitate to reach out to me through my website, excelcloud.com. So now you have this handy tool to download your data And my recommendation is that use this tool just to get your data. Once your data is downloaded, like we have over here, move the data to another file for your final analysis. And that's it. I hope you guys find this Excel tool useful. And again, this is where you can download that file. I've also put together other free tools you may find helpful, and you can find all of them on my free tools page on my website as well as on my YouTube channel. So let me know what you guys think about this tool, and if you have ideas for other Excel tools, feel free to leave me a comment. And if this tool is able to help you save some time or work, make sure you like this video and subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.